That's where I want to introduce our special guest this morning. We have Steve Jackson, who's here to talk about. Welcome, Steve. Thanks for coming in. And we have Ray Shimizu. Thanks, Steve, for coming in. And I know this has been a little bit of history, but it's very important to set the stage for what they're going to talk about here with the inflation that's going on. So, Steve, tell us a little bit about yourself and how you're involved with sound money. Does that mean it's musical, or what does sound money mean here?
Well, it's not quite musical, but it is very interesting. I got involved with sound money, which is another name for gold and silver. I got involved with sound money because, as Dan had relived our history, I began to understand that where our money seemed to be going, it was so important that I ensure my money. Many people have experienced, or many countries have experienced, catastrophe over currency. And so it seemed as though it would make sense to just ensure the money that I have. So therefore, I got interested in gold and silver. I'm an online marketer. And a lot of times I have products that I actually present to people that really help them to better their lives, grow their business, whatever the case may be. And I got the opportunity to collaborate with a company that was making it easy for just the average individual to attain gold and silver. And so I've had opportunities to do it in the past, but I never took it seriously. But as I found out or learned about money, and as Dan had given us that history, many people today do not realize that the U.S. dollar is no longer backed by gold, making it a what we call a fiat currency. And so because of that, I took it much more seriously. I've had some financial reversals. And so thinking about what money is and how it really works, it helped me to appreciate how important it was to have some type of gold and silver. There was a survey done back in 2017. And in that survey, it asked several people, and 44% of the people said this: if they had a $400 emergency expense, that they would not be able to cover that expense unless they either borrowed money, sold money, or even gotten a loan. And so people wonder, well, what is happening with our money? It seems like we have less and less of it, even though we may get the same amount of money on a weekly basis from our job or whatever our livelihood is. It seems like we have less and less money. If we think about the U.S. dollar, back in 1965, $1 was almost equal to an ounce of silver. I think the difference was about 29 cents. When we think about how much the value of an ounce of silver was, but let's consider it as being just as equal. And so then you could buy a car, a Mustang, with $2,500. You can also buy that same Mustang with 2,500 ounces of silver. But today, could you buy a Ford Mustang with $2,500? Absolutely not. You may be able to pay for the tires and rims, but today you could buy a Mustang and a half with 25 ounces of silver. So we can see how our money has, our value has diminished. In fact, in today's time, the power of our money, or our buying power of our money, is only about 5 cents. Imagine that. And then when we think about the buying power of silver, it's increased drastically. Now let's talk about gold. Now gold, back in 1965, if you bought a home for $10,000 USD, today that home would be worth about $85,000. Now that $10,000 would equate to 281 ounces of gold. So if you were to consider what the value of that gold is today, it would be more than $500,000. So back then, if we bought a home with 281 ounces of gold, today we will have in that 281 ounces, we would have over $500,000. That's mind-boggling. There is no reason why we would not consider gold and silver. But what makes it so important today is that it is accessible to just the average individual. And it wasn't that way before, but today it is accessible.
So Steve, let's come back to you. We mentioned the website, buysilvergold.us, but that's just one opportunity for people to get some information. There's some links there to buy products, to put some money in, the sound wallet feature and so forth. But what is this whole concept of inflation and the valuation of gold and silver?
Well, as we realize that the USD currency has lost some of its buying power, prices naturally go up. And they've gone up to the point where it's just difficult to make ends meet at times because of the way prices have gone up. And so having said that, that's why having some type of protection or some type of insurance is important. And one of the, a good protection against that is gold and silver. Gold and silver has been around since the beginning of time, and it will still be here. Gold and silver maintains its value because of the rarity. It is the rarity of something that gives its value. So if we print money, like we have a tree in the backyard, there's no longer a rarity. And so the currency will lose its value. Thus, prices will increase.
And these days, the government is printing billions of dollars of currency, paper money. And like we mentioned before, the more they print, the less value each dollar has. Mm-hmm. So prices are going up. We think of prices going up, but really what it means is that the dollar value is going down. So in cases of hyperinflation, like we've seen in some countries around the world, you'll need a wheelbarrow to carry all the cash, if you will, the currency into the store to buy a loaf of bread. That's where the dollar, the currency, paper money that has no reference, no anchor to gold is losing the value. And that's why if you have a little bit of silver, a little bit of gold, it can help with your investment there. Stephen, tell us a little bit about some of the physical pieces. You have some samples here with us, I think you and Ray. Maybe show us some of these things that we can get. All of us normal human beings, we're not the wealthy, but we can buy some pieces and hold it in our own possession and keep it safe.
Yes, absolutely. First, I want to refer back to that site. On the site buysilvergold.us, there's a program called AutoSaver. And in that program, it helps you actually buy silver, buy gold. And the reason for that is because people just would not know what to buy. What do they look for? How they know they're getting the right product? How do they know they're not getting a counterfeit coin? So through this program, it eliminates all of that. Now, this group of people wanted to help everyone to avoid a $1.2 million mistake. And that is, in 1986, when the American Silver Eagle began, if we'd have bought one coin per month up until now, we probably would have spent about $40,000, but it'd be worth $1.2 million. So that makes you want to start now.
And that would be buying one coin a month for all those since 1965?
Since 1986.
86?
Yes.
Okay.
So if we bought one coin per month until then, it'd be worth $1.2 million.
So we're investing one coin a month, budgeting for that in that scenario, that hypothetical, if we would just budget one coin a month, whatever the price is of silver, then it would have cost us over that time, you say $40,000,
$50,000. Exactly.
But it would be worth a lot more today.
$1.2 million.
$1.2 million.
Makes us want to get started right now.
Let's start buying coins, one a month. So you said that's the AutoSaver program.
Yes. So, and that is, how do we get a coin once a month? So through the AutoSaver program, we have some coins here. And
you can hold them up to the camera there a little bit.
These are numismatic coins. And what they are, they're coins, pure silver. They have a MS70. grading. And what that does is that just lets us know the purity of the coin. They're graded by NGC, which is a grading company, worldwide grading company, and they actually certify that the coin is authentic. So this coin has not been touched by human hands. But this is the type of coin that you can actually get through the Autosaver program on a monthly basis. And these coins, what's so unique about these coins is not only that they're graded and that they're packaged in this way, but they're rare. You're not going to find 100,000 coins of this like around. And as I mentioned before, it is the rarity of a coin that makes it valuable. So this coin really can increase in value inside of a year. It just depends. So, but this is the type of coin that you would actually get if you were in that Autosaver program.
Or you could just buy one here and there, now and then, if they just wanted to try it out, buy one coin and see what it's like and hold it in your hand.
Absolutely. In fact, a good idea, a good example of buying a coin. Now, this is a 5-ounce coin.
Whoa.
Miss Liberty coin. This coin here was in representation of 9/11. It's to commemorate that moment. I think about 911 of these coins were created. So you can just see how rare the coins are as far as the amount of mintage. It's not 100,000 or a million. It's just a few. But as time goes on, these coins will be widely sought after. And so that's what increases their value. But this is the type of coin you can actually purchase at any given time. And there's so many different varieties. There's enough to go around, but they actually will help you to increase your wealth.
Now, that site at buysilvergold.us is one site where anybody can go there and click on the product link, and you can scroll down and see some of the different coins, the Liberty coins, silver and gold. There's some silver gold jewelry. There's some other bullion and things there. So there's no specific cost to start with other than the cost of buying that coin. But it also, in addition to that, you can buy one coin for $50 fractional silver or gold, or you can buy an ounce for whatever the price is there. You can buy that, order that, and get that. But it's also a membership type program, kind of like going to Costco, Ray said, where you pay for a membership and then you have the opportunity to shop there and get some of the benefit of the prices.